जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग फाइन। आई हैव ऑलरेडी शेयर्ड द फर्स्ट मॉड्यूल ऑफ दिस चैप्टर अंडरस्टैंडिंग मार्जिनलाइजेशन, एंड वी हैड डिस्कस्ड इन द क्लास दैट व्हाट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस टर्म, व्हाट इज द लिटरल मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड आदिवासीज, व्हाट लैंग्वेज डू दे स्पीक, एंड वी हैड ऑल्सो डन अ केस स्टडी। सो लेट अस कंटिन्यू फर्दर। वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट आदिवासीज एंड स्टीरियोटाइपिंग, but I will give you a recap. Like stereotypic means when you have a image which is not exactly the same in reality. So when the term adivasis come into our mind, we think of colorful costumes, headgear, and their unique way of dancing. Besides this, we seem to know very little about their reality of life. This often wrongly leads to people believing that they are exotic, primitive, and somewhat backward. Often, Adivasis are blamed for the lack of advancement, as they are believed to be resistant to any new change. We had read in the class 6 how a stereotype leads to discrimination among people. The next topic we will do is Adivasis and development. As we have already read in the history texts that forests are absolutely crucial for the development of all empires and settled civilizations. Why? Because they are a source of a number of things like metal, ore, then this animal products, herbs, plants, and etc., which all come from these forests. In addition, the continuation of life depended heavily on the forest that helped recharge many of the India's rivers and is becoming clear now, which is crucial to the availability and equality of our air and water. Then a forest covered the major part of the country till the 19th century, and these Adivasis had a deep knowledge or access as well as control over most of the vast tracts till the middle of the 19th century. This meant that they were not ruled by large states and empires. We are talking about the 19th century. Instead, often empires, they heavily dependent on these Adivasis for getting things from the forests, or they wanted to take the forest resources. This is radically contrary to our image of Adivasis today as somewhat marginal and powerless. They have become some marginal and powerless communities. In the pre-colonial period, they were traditionally range hunter-gatherers and nomads, and they lived by shifting agriculture and also cultivating in one place. Although these remain for the past 200 years, the Adivasis have been increasingly forced because of various reasons, or like economic changes or forest policies or various political forces, where they were forced to migrate and move to different places, and they started to work at construction sites, in industries, and also as domestic workers. So slowly their life changed. For the first time in the history, they did not control or have much direct access to the forest territories. So see, we can see a gradual change in their lives. The problems which are faced by the Adivasis: the forest lands have been cleared up because of for a number of purposes, like timber, like industries are being set up, or for agriculture and so on. Adivasis, those who have lived there in areas which are rich in minerals and other natural resources, mining has taken place there, and they have been forced to leave their lands. Then there are powerful forces we have seen which take over the tribal land, and much of the time the land is taken forcefully, which we all know. According to official figures, more than 50% of the persons displaced due to mines and mining projects are the tribals. Another recent survey report by the organizations working among Adivasis show that 79% of the persons displaced from the states of Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, and so on are the tribals, and their lands have gone under the water because dams have been set up or new things have been built there. Then in northeastern state, the lands have been highly militarized, means military people have taken over, or it has been war torn. Then there are areas where tribals originally lived, but they have been forced to leave that place. When they continue to stay in these forests, they are termed as encroacher. Encroacher means when you are living in somebody else's land. losing their land and access to the forest means that these tribals have lost their main source of livelihood. They have no other work. Having gradually lost access to their own traditional homelands, many Adivasis have migrated to cities in search of work, where they are employed at very low wages in industries or building or construction sites. Thus, they get caught in a cycle of poverty and they are deprived of many things. 45% of the tribal groups in rural areas and 35% in urban areas live below the poverty line. This leads to a number of people of these children of these people getting malnourished. The literacy rate among these tribals is also very low. So when Adivasis are displaced from the lands, they lose much of their source of income. This is all for the second module. We will be discussing about this minorities and marginalizations in the marginalization in the next module. Thank you.